Welcome to Lorelei's Classic Kitchen. And today in my kitchen, I'm going to be doing red chili or chili rojo. And sorry, I haven't been on for a while, but I've been battling laryngitis. I still have my voice that's a little bit still cracky, but I'm trying to make this video for you guys. So come on in. For this, you're going to be needing some New Mexico chilies and Guajillo chilies. And I have 6 pounds total, 3 pounds a piece. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean these out and take out the seeds and devein them. And then I'm gonna put them in this pan to boil. And while it's boiling, I'm gonna cut up the meat. And for this recipe, I'm using 3 pounds of it's beef boneless sirloin or milanesa. And I'm gonna also use 2 tomatoes, 9 cloves of garlic. Remember, this is gonna give you that flavor. We like the flavor, so you want good tasting chili rojo, then you're gonna wanna use some garlic in there. And then to that, I'm also using some chicken bouillon or, you know, any kind of dried chicken bouillon. And then I'm also using some comino or cumin, and it looks brown. Kind of smells like armpits, but it'll give that meat good flavor. And then also to that, I'm gonna be using some flour along with about a tablespoon of any kind of oil. You just don't wanna get olive oil, cause that kind of has a strong flavor, but I'm probably gonna use avocado oil, but you can use sunflower oil or canola oil, whatever you wanna use, but that's what I'm using. So now I'm gonna take out the seeds and I'm gonna put it to boil and I'll show you that. Chili has been deveined and taken out most of the seeds. Now you don't have to get every speck of the seeds out because you're gonna grind it and strain it anyway. So just get as much as you can out because it'll make your job easier. But this is again 3 ounces of Guajillo and 3 ounces of New Mexico chili. So now when we cut our meat, I'm gonna put this to boil. So it can soften those chilies, so when we blend them up, it'll get all those flavors incorporated together. So now I'm gonna cut the meat up. Now as you cut these up, you're gonna just kinda wanna dice them, cube them. Just like this. Just kinda cube them. Now this is how you're gonna want them to look after you boil them. See how softened they are? And all the juice in there. And you're gonna set aside your juice and your chilies because I'm gonna grind them up. But here's the 2 tomatoes that I roasted a little bit. And I'm gonna be sticking that in my blender once they cool off a little bit. But right now I'm gonna start my flame on my meat. And I'm gonna put it on a medium high. And once you put it on a medium high, I'm gonna take my avocado oil and I'm gonna put about maybe a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half of oil along with all those cloves of garlic that we, you can either mince them up or I just use my garlic smasher for it, so just depends on whatever you have, you know, to your ability. Just use it. Just, you know, if you have a smasher, just smash it. Go ahead and smash that. But I'm going to cook this up right now. And once I get this cooked up a little bit, I'll show you how I blend that and grind that. My meat's been cooking for a little bit with the salt and pepper and garlic. And it's still warm, my chili, but that's okay. It's gonna just be softened anyways. And when you put it in here, just be careful with the steam. That's just gonna be the difference on it. But if you see that you're choking when you're cooking the chili, that's from the chili, because it's probably gonna be a little hot. But I'm used to it, I guess, because my mom and dad always used to cook chili and then choke on it when you walked in the door. So anyways, go ahead and put your chilies in your blender. Okay, I put the chili in there with some of the juice, and the two tomatoes that I roasted, I'm just gonna just throw them in there. Dumping them in. And I have this bowl set aside. It's like a thin strainer or cauldron with an extra bowl, and this is what you're gonna end up straining your chili out afterwards with it, and I'll show you that. But now I'm just gonna put the lid on and give this little puppy a blend. Been blended up with your tomatoes and your two types of chili, and you're just gonna want to put in your strainer. And the reason why I do this is because I grew up with my dad doing this. I know some people don't strain their chili, but I've had it unstrained, and there's like cascaras in there, as my dad would call it, which is the skin and everything, and he just don't want to bite into that. I know I like it the way that my mom and dad always did it, and this is how I'm gonna continue to do it. But just go ahead and circle it and just kind of, you know, push it so you get all the chili out of there, but you don't get like the skin. And it's even catching all of the skin from the tomato that I roasted. You can see that. And you're just gonna be left with chili in your bowl. Now, if you don't use all of your chili, just save it for when you make enchiladas. And if I don't use it all, I'll show you how I use it in enchiladas and the process of that. It's gonna kind of be the same thing, but not, but I'll show you that in another video. But just keep on like pushing it towards the bottom and kind of like this. See, if you don't, you know, strain this out, this is what you're gonna get left with, and you don't wanna bite into that. I know I don't, and I don't like it. I've had it both ways, and believe me, I like it this way better. Now, this is how you're gonna want it to look. Look how smooth that is. That's how you want your chili. You don't want all that junk inside of it, the chili cascaras, as my dad would say, and the seeds and everything. But this is smooth, and we're gonna take this, and I'm gonna come over here to my pan that I've been turning the meat in between with my garlic and my salt and pepper, and see how it's already almost all cooked. You have a few couple of pieces in here that are a little red, but I'm gonna take my some flour, about a fourth of a cup of flour to that. And what the flour does is it just thickens it, so your meat will have some thickness to it, won't be so soupy. And once you incorporate the flour, you want to make sure you cook it with the flour for a little bit, just to get that raw flour taste out of it. See how it already like thickened it? Just like that.
Yeah, baby.
And your heat's still gonna be, now you're gonna raise it to a little like medium high. And at this point as well, I'm gonna add a little bit of cumin and maybe about a fourth of a teaspoon right now. But I have to taste this. You're gonna wanna taste it again. Taste your food and make it to your liking. If you don't like it, you know, too much salt, or if you don't like specific things, then don't put them in. But this is the way I grew up, this is the way I had it, and this is the way this man on my apron taught me how to cook. And I just do it the way my mom and dad taught me, so. See, now that you have that, you're gonna wanna add your chili mixture in and just pour it in, just like this. And I'm probably gonna use the whole thing, the whole 6 ounces, yep. That was perfect for the 3 pounds of meat, 6 ounces of chili, and 2 tomatoes. Once you got your chili mixture in there and just mix it on in. And now I'm gonna put the caldo de pollo, or your chicken base, into the mixture. And right now I'm gonna put like a teaspoon, and then I'm gonna taste it, mix it, and then taste it. That's your whole key to all your food. Look at that, the smoothness of that sauce, all those spices, and the smell in the house. It's just like wonderful. So make sure you try this recipe. You won't be sorry, I promise. Now, taste it. See, once you taste it, I see that it needs a little more comino and some more caldo de pollo, which is 2 teaspoons now, and also some salt, about a teaspoon of salt. Sorry, it's hard to come out because it's my pink salt, my pink Himalayan salt, so it's harder to shake it on out. Come on out of that salt shaker. And once you have it in here like this and you incorporate your spices, you're gonna wanna let it boil a little bit. I know my dad, he used to add also like nopales to it. If you like nopales, you can add green beans, you can add whatever you like in here. It just makes it that extra special. It makes it yours, so. You can even add papas. I know they would add potatoes sometimes, but you have to taste everything. See, you gotta keep on tasting. And once I incorporate that, I'm gonna put some more salt in there. Because like I said, the chili don't have any saltiness or any kind of like flavor. That gives you the heat and that specific taste of your New Mexico and Guajillo chili. So you're gonna wanna make sure you taste everything. It's getting there. It's getting there. A little more salt. So that was probably about maybe 2 teaspoons of salt, 1 teaspoon of cumin. Well, now 1.5 teaspoons of cumin, and maybe like maybe 1/4 of caldo de pollo, and just mixed it. Get it to your likings and to your taste. Once I see that, Yeah. It's got that pica to it too. If you don't like it as spicy, just don't add as much chili, but this gives it, it's not too spicy because I'm a wimp when it comes to spice anyways, but my dad would always call me a wimp, but just eat it, eat the chili, but I like it spicy, but not like over spicy. That's why you want to use the New Mexico chilies and the guajillos together. It'll give it a good flavor. Or you could just use all New Mexico. It's your choice. See, that's good. I'm all that's good. And then you're just gonna let it simmer. Let it simmer for a little bit and get all those flavors engulfed and all that yumminess going on in that pan. So when we come back, I'll show you, I'll taste it for you and do the honors for you of tasting that meat. Okay, this has been after 30 to 35 minutes. Look at all that yumminess and the juice with the spices and that garnet. Anyways, I whipped up some homemade tortillas and I'm gonna take a bite of this. Please try this. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to Lorelei's Classic Kitchen, where you can come into my home and I'll welcome you and I'll have more of these yummy recipes. I'll be seeing you soon.